tacky glue or hot glue, that works great too. But I think this is safer for some reason, because I know this is acid-free, and I'm sure tacky glue also is acid-free, but the hot glue might be too warm for the paper. Be a different story if it was felt. But we don't want a felt scrapbook page, depends. Okay, so we're gonna keep gluing down. Make sure that you evenly coat it with glue. Don't put a big stack, the phone rang, a big stack of glue in one area. So it's evenly glued. I'm going to put the clock in place later. I want to have everything glued down first, one step at a time, so we don't forget. That happens when you get a big glob of glue. Just make sure that you smooth it out and coat it in all the areas of the letter. Okay, skip the E. I know there's a lot of noise in my house. Sorry if you heard the microwave. Maybe I should film my videos in the basement, but my mom's drying her hair down there, so not a good idea. But, okay, almost done, just bear with me. It will be worth it. You'll have something cute to remember in the year. If you want to, since they're like the same colors, if you want to make the top shadow letter stand out, you could line it with some golden glitter glue, or maybe silver, but I think gold is best. But I'm not going to waste my glitter glue on that. I'm going to use that for the E. But I'm going to make sure everything's smoothed down, completely stick. Wish it was sticky back on the back of the other paper too. But that the ease. So now we are going to place the clock. So we're gonna take this sticker, move it on the sheet, and we're gonna place it between the Y and the N. It's cute, adds a little accent. I'm just gonna, now my favorite part is glitter glue. I'm gonna make sure that, okay, now remember to do this. I was making sure you take out that plug. They do that so it doesn't dry up in the store, when sometimes it does, but if you want to test it out, you could. But I think I have my control. A good way to get used to this and to practice this, if you want it to come out nice, is if you pipe with a pastry bag like I do, because I love to cake decorate. That's some practice. So you're going to trace over that outline. And what you're going to do is you're just going to squeeze evenly with some pressure with your writing hand. So my writing hand is right. So you could use two hands to kind of guide it along if you'd like. And fold that cap up so it doesn't distract you and get in your way. So you're just going to line. I want the letters. Actually, looks pretty cute. Just going to go over it, just like piping. Do you want to fill it in? You can, but I actually think it looks cute that way. I think it would be kind of a waste of glue. So like I said, you're going to, I'll see if I could do it backwards for you. Don't put your hand on the other one. Now we're going to go over that outline. So, there, do it from the side. Put it on there. You don't have to go this fast. Just lift it up, because it makes the line straighter than if you were going down. More precise that way. Because when you pipe with a pastry bag, you also do that. And it actually makes the lawn look nicer. So, you shouldn't lift it up like me because it might fall. You should let it set. But that's what it looks like, the ease. And they look cute. Get a pretty accent to it. What I'd like to do is take, I have like a punch out thing last year on my letters, like the ones that have holes in the middle, like A, R, and T. I put stars, see? And I put silver stars, but I have my heart punch out and I have gold glittery paper. It's kind of hard because the paper is very thick